Good day, everybody. I am Dr. Anaita Urwadia Hegde, pediatric neurologist affiliated to the Jaslok Hospital, SRCC Children's Hospital, Wadia Hospital, and Breach Candy Hospital. But most important, as the medical director of the Jai Vakil Foundation. And it is in that capacity that I am addressing you today. Given the present pandemic, COVID pandemic, I felt it would be nice to address you to highlight certain medical guidelines that I would like if you all could follow. These are not just for the children, but also for the parents, the staff, and all those who may be associated with the Jai Vakil Foundation in any capacity. While the government is working overtime to try and help us with healthcare facilities, essentials, lockdowns, containment zones, and seeing that the virus does not reach us, you do realize that this is an influenza virus of sorts. There's a very high chance that many of us will get infected sometime or the other in the immediate or in the coming future. For the same, we would recommend a few things to try and boost your immunity so that the day you do catch the infection, you are as healthy as you can be. The first thing we recommend is that you need to sleep well. You need to have at least 8 to 10 hours of sleep, 10 maybe for the children, but at least 8 hours for the adults on a daily basis. Look at the plus of it. You're sitting at home, so this is the best time to catch up on your sleep. The next thing is hydrate yourself. See that you drink adequate amount of fluids, preferably 2 to 3 liters per day. Ideally, this should be as much as warm water you can sip throughout the day is recommended. The next thing is exercise. We recommend at least 30 minutes to 60 minutes an hour of light exercise on a daily basis. I know we have space constraints. I know you are all locked down and it's not easy to do so. But whatever can be done within your capacity, you should try. You can go on the YouTube. You can look for certain videos which fit your fitness level and do simple exercises, but in repetitions so that you can do 30 minutes of that. Home remedies. Yes, I know many of you do believe in haldi and ginger and a host of home remedies. I recommend you do continue to take them. Anything to boost your immunity is good, but do not believe that you cannot get the infection if you keep consuming large quantities of these remedies. The last and most important, I would say, is a good healthy diet, which is less in oil, less spices, less deep fried stuff, and lower on sugars. Nothing is banned, nothing is restricted, but yes, we don't want a lot of high artificial sugars, particularly sitting at home with nothing to do, we tend to eat more than we actually need to. So in addition to these few health tips, there are certain vitamins that we recommend to boost your immunity, namely vitamin C, vitamin D, and zinc supplements, which you can get at any common chemist down the corner freely. Without even necessarily a regular prescription. So if you can source those, we recommend you take a small quantity on a daily basis so that you boost your immunity further. Now, in addition to this, you do realize that this virus spreads particularly through air as well as through surfaces. So what do we recommend? And you are all aware of it by now. Hand washing. Number one, wash your hands regularly for 20 to 40 seconds properly with soap and water. Sanitizers are there, but there is nothing as good as hand washing. There are systems, and you must have seen them on the YouTube or on the WhatsApp, as to how to wash so that no corner of the hand is left out. The next important thing is the mask. Cover your mouth with a mask. It doesn't have to be an N95, which is really only for healthcare workers. Cloth masks, surgical masks, even a hanky at the end of the day, but something needs to cover your mouth so that you prevent the spread of the virus. It's under a lot of debate how beneficial it is, but there is no question about it that countries which cover their mouth with masks definitely had better outcomes as compared to those which didn't. So we recommend when the minute you step out of your house, You will cover your mouth with a mask till you come back inside. These masks, if they are N95, some of them are washable and reusable. Even if they are not, the cloth ones you can wash and reuse. The others we recommend you put them out in sunlight. The UV light will disinfect it and you can use it again after 24 hours. So we recommend that each member should have two masks, one for today, which gets disinfected tomorrow, and one for tomorrow, which gets disinfected the next day. So while we are all going out with masks, we are also aware that social distancing is important. A minimum distance of 2 meters or 6 feet is what is recommended. You step into a shop, you step into common areas, irrespective of what other people do, please space yourself from the next person, because the virus only has a certain distant capacity that it can travel. The last and very important aspect is this virus does not do well in hot and humid climates. We are lucky again, the summer is coming, the hot sweltering heat with the humidity is already here. So open your windows, let the ventilation, let your house be ventilated with natural breeze and natural air. Air conditions are not recommended, because by keeping the temperatures in your homes low, you are allowing the virus to stay dormant and live longer than it would in heat or in humidity. And the last and most important thing is that a large percentage of our children, parents, staff are on medications for other issues. Some are for behavior, some for epilepsy, some for diabetes, blood pressure, sugars, asthma, liver infections, kidney related disorders. Whatever be the medical condition, do not stop your medication at any cost. Do not change your medication. Do not stop your medication. See that you have at least 1 month's stock available with you at any given time, and see that you take your medication regularly. Do not self-medicate. There are lots of articles of different drugs which are being considered for prophylaxis, for treatment, but this is not for regular lay people to go out, buy and start treating yourself. Every medicine has associated side effects of it, and it should only be your doctor, your physician, your GP who will prescribe this medicine for you if he thinks it is necessary. So in your anxiety and in your fear, don't run out and start treating yourself thinking that you can prevent or block the infection from coming in. I know you are anxious. I know you are worried for yourselves, for your children, for your elderly parents. I am too. We all are. But this is just a regular infection. It's going to come and it's going to go. It's going to hit a lot of people in the bargain. I do not deny that. But if you are healthy and if you look after yourself well, there is a good chance that even if you get it, you will come out of it sailing with no complications and no concerns. At the end of the day, we'd like to say that we are always there for you as a member of the Jai Vakil team. And if ever anybody has any concerns, needs, questions, we are happy to support you at any time. Thank you.